Integration by parts with usup. Is there a reason why this integral is correct on the right side but it doesn't form the original integral on the left? I keep getting 2x on the left side after my third attempt. Alright, let's have a look. So the question is, we have this integral, the integral of sine of ln of 2x. And then after all that work, somehow we end up with this extra 2 right here. And on the right hand side here, this is already the correct answer. Oh, I should include a plus c. And of course, you have to just reduce the numbers. But this right here is already the correct answer. Now we can see that right here. So why do we have that extra 2? That's the main question. So now let's go over the steps. So the integral is that. And what you did first is you took a u sub. You let u equal to the inside. So u is equal to 2x, differentiating both sides. And divide the 2 on both sides, dx equals du over 2. Then you took this integral from the x world to the u world, dx is du over 2. Right? Dx is du over 2. And then the 2x is the u. So that's what we have. And then we have the 1 half. So you put that out. Good. And then here we have 1 half integral of sine of ln u. This right here, if you do a substitution, it will be easier. And that's exactly what you did. You put v to b ln u, and then differentiating both sides, dv equals 1 over u du, and then du equals u dv after we multiply u on both sides. And I want to emphasize this right here. This right here is just another substitution. We're just using u substitution and then v substitution. This right here is not integration by parts yet, just substitution. So yeah, just keep that in mind. All right, there's one thing that's bad because we have the u right here in the v world. That's no good. So we look at this equation. Exponentiate both sides. So e to this power, e to that power. And then we get that. In another word, u equals e to the v. So we can put that down here. Great. Now we have the 1 half still in the front. Integral and then sine of v, which is d ln u, and then du is precisely just that. So far, so good. And now, this right here is the tricky part. Let me erase all that. Keep in mind, this thing right here is what we want. And here's the deal. When we have the integral of sine times e to whatever, in this one in particular, integral of e to the a number that say a times x times sine or cosine, right? Both work the same. And then say another number bx. This kind of integral required integration by parts. And it's the third step in the DI method, meaning you will get a repeating case. So keep that in mind. But when you have a repeating case, you have to be extra careful. Especially we have a factor in the front. We have the 1 half in the front. So that is the part right there. And what you did was, you used the DI method for the integration by parts. So either you include 1 half with the e to the v, or you include 1 half next to the sine v, because you still have to multiply by 1 half. Well, that's one part that's missing. So that's how you can do it. If you include the 1 half, okay. But if you do this, this is still okay. But you just have to remember, when you do this, you are just integrating e to the v times sine v dv, right? So we differentiated e to the v, and then we integrated sine v, and then the plus minus plus on the side, and then differentiating e to the v is just e to the v, and then integrating sine v, we get negative cosine v, and then do it again, we get negative sine v. All right, so right here, we multiply this and that, and this and that, they will be the first two parts of the answer. And let me just write this down for you guys nicely. E to the v times negative cosine v, so that's negative e to the v cosine v. And then next, we will have, remember this is a negative, so negative e to the v, and then also negative sine phi, so that will be a positive e to the phi sine phi. And don't forget that we still have to multiply the last row and then put that inside of integral. And be careful, here we have a negative here, so it's a subtraction. So we will have to subtract the integral of what we had earlier, which is e to the phi sine phi d phi. And as you can see, this is a repeat situation. So we can just move this to the other side, combine them, just like 1 plus another 1. So we get two integrals of e to the phi sine phi d phi. And that will be equal to this right here. Let me just copy and paste. Okay, then we can just divide both sides by 2, like this. So they cancel. And then, ladies and gentlemen, integral of e to the phi sine phi d phi equals, I'll put 1/2 in the front, and then negative e to the phi cosine phi plus e to the phi sine phi. And let's not worry about the plus yet, because we are not done. All right, so that will give us the answer for just this integral. And here's the deal though. Remember, we really want to have the 1/2. So make sure that after you did all that, you still multiply both sides by 1/2, because that's what we want. So just do this. So we will end up with 1/2 integral e to the phi sine phi d phi equals, of course, 1/2 times 1/2, we have the 1/4. And then the rest, negative e to the phi cosine phi plus e to the phi sine phi. Yeah. So that's pretty much the main issue. We have to look for this integral, not like the one without the 1/2. So that's that. And then, of course, right here, what you did was, it looks like, because here I see that you have the 1/2, and then somehow the 1/2 becomes right here. So it looks like, to me, you divide both sides by 1, you divide both sides by 2. And I'm not quite sure if I follow, and then it looks like you multiply the 2 back here again. So whichever way that you did, you somehow end up with this integral here, right? You have the integral of sine phi e to the phi d phi, and that's not it. You must have the 1/2. 1/2 here. So if you multiply by the 1/2, you know, throw this out. Well, if you multiply by the 1/2, throw out this equation, the left-hand side is right, this and that cancel, but you will have an extra factor 2 right here, right? So it's, I think somewhere you just, from here to here, that you probably divide both sides by 2, which you are not supposed to do, right? So that's the issue. So if you follow right here, right, once we have that, you see this is what we want. Then we can just go back to the x world. So I will do that for you. 1/4, negative e, the phi is ln u, and then we have cosine of ln u, and then plus e to the ln u, and then sine of ln u. Okay. And then this right here is just equal to u, right? Likewise, this right here is just equal to u. And remember, u is equal to 2x. So this right here is 1/4 times negative, and we have 2x, and then we have cosine of ln of u is 2x, and then plus 2x, and then we have sine of ln of 2x. 1, 2, 3. All right, and now of course, if you divide the 2s, you end up with 1/2, right? Because you have the factor 2, so just take care of that number. So you have the 1/2, and then parentheses negative x cosine of ln of 2x, and then plus x sine of ln of 2x. And then we're all done. Finally, put plus c. And this right here is the answer that we had earlier right here. So hopefully this right here helps. But before we go, let me show you an easier way. An easier way that you don't have to worry about the 1/2 is the following. This thing, ln of 2x, by the log property, is just ln 2 plus ln x. If you break them apart and you put that to be u, and then you get the derivative of ln 2 is 0, and then the derivative of ln x is just 1 over x, dx. And then you can continue from there, and you don't have to worry about the 2. Yeah, so I'm going to leave that to you to figure out, but it's this 1/2 that's annoying, and you have to do it super, super carefully. It's not just a matter of look at what this equation here, and then multiply both sides by 1/2. It's not like that. So hopefully this right here helps.